Praise the Lord. Let us lift up the name of Jesus. We are here in the house of the Lord to give glory and praise to God. And at this moment, hallelujah, let us forget where we are. Let us put aside our differences. Let us put our voices together. Let us lift up the name of Jesus because he's worthy to be praised. Hallelujah. And this evening, this morning, I do pray many of you are in your homes, wherever you are, listen to us online. I know the Spirit of God is there, and I know, bless the Lord, there is a blessing awaiting you. And so we're going to worship the Lord right now. We give you praise and thanks. Just lift your hands and say, thank you, Jesus. We bless your name, Lord. We give you glory. We give you praise. We thank you for this morning. We thank you that we can lift your name. We thank you that, oh God, you're giving us the strength today. Hallelujah. There is nothing missing, nothing broken over us, oh God. And so we're going to glorify you, oh God. You are worthy. You're worthy to be praised. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. To you be the glory and the honor. Hallelujah. We're going to glorify the Lord right now with this song. Hallelujah. Lift your hands and give God praise as we glorify the Lord. Let praises rise from the inside. Oh, yeah. From the inside. Delight, hallelujah, in his presence. Delight in the glory of the Lord, hallelujah. Ask the Lord for a fresh infilling.
From the inside.
Yes, this is what the Lord desires of you this morning.
Oh, yeah, Lord. Set me on fire.
Oh, yeah, Lord.
From the inside.
Yeah, from the inside.
From the inside.
Inside.
Good morning to one and all. We are so glad that you have joined us as we say welcome to the Christian Mission Worship Time live stream. I know you've been enjoying the worship. I have too. I just feel like we're in the presence of God, and I just feel like we can pray for a minute. Father, we do thank you that we just want praises to be continually arising out of our being, dear Lord. It's a time of worship and praise. It's a time that we send up our sacrifice of praise and worship. And we're saying, let praises rise from the inside. We just want to glorify you, exalt you. Your presence is so awesome. We feel so refreshed and refined in your presence. Have your way in today's worship service time, Lord. I pray, God, that all will be richly blessed in a special way. Anoint your speaker and let your word resonate, Lord, within our hearts. In Jesus' name, amen. Yes, it's so good that you're here. Today, we will be hearing from one of our pastors, but before we get there, I just want to read a few scriptures for you. If you have your Bibles, turn with me, please. And the first set of scriptures we'll be reading from is Matthew, the 16th chapter, verse 15 and 16. And this is how it reads. He said unto them, but whom say ye that I am? And Simon Peter answered and said, thou art the Christ, the Son of the living God. We'll proceed next to read from the book of Exodus, the third chapter and verse 7. And this is how it reads. Exodus 3:7. This is so important because it's the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords, Jehovah God himself speaking. And he said, it reads, and the Lord said, I have surely seen the affliction of my people which are in Egypt, and have heard their cry by reason of their taskmasters, for I know their sorrows. Okay, we're going to do some more reading for you. And we're going now straight to the book of St. John. And we're reading from the second chapter of John. And it reads here in John, the second chapter, just two verses again, verse 4 and 5. Jesus said unto her, woman, what have I to do with thee? Mine hour is not yet come. His mother said unto the servants, whatsoever he said unto you, do it. Then we have in verse 7 and 8, Jesus said unto them, fill the water pots with water. And they filled them up to the brim. And he said unto them, draw out and now bear unto the governor of the feast. And they bear it. Still have some more of God's word. God's word is so rich, it's so powerful, it is so beautiful. It is a man of God, I think it's Jeremiah, one of them said, he just wanted to eat up the word of God. So here we go again. We're going to Matthew now, and we're going to read from the 8th chapter of Matthew, right? And verse 24 through 27. And this is how it reads. Matthew 8. And that will be the 8th chapter, 24 through 27. And behold, there arose a great tempest in the sea, insomuch that the ship was covered with the waves, but he was asleep. And his disciples came to him and awoke him, saying, Lord, save us, we perish. And he said unto them, why are ye so fearful, O ye of little faith? Then he arose and rebuked the winds and the sea, and there was a great calm. Verse 27, but the men marveled, saying, what manner of man is this, that even the winds and the sea obey him? We still want to read one more, and this is becoming very interesting as we look into the Word of God. And we're going over back to the book of St. John. And we're reading now the sixth chapter of John. And we're going to read just two verses there, verse 5 and 6. And this is how it reads, St. John 6, sorry, verse 5 and 6. Good, here we go. When Jesus lifted up his eyes and saw a great company come unto him, he said unto Philip, whence shall we buy bread that these may eat? And this he said to prove him, for he himself knew what he would do. I just love to read God's word. I anticipate today God is really going to be stirring up our pure minds as we put our trust and faith in him that he can do all things. Just in case you've joined us, is the Christian Mission live stream, worship time live stream rather, coming your way every Sunday around this time, around 10:30, and we encourage you to join us every Sunday until we resume normal services in our churches. The worshipers are going to come back and they're going to continue, and you joining and lift up your hands and lift up your voices and exalt the Lord and worship at his footstool. God bless you.
Hallelujah, Jesus. Here we are, standing in your presence. Here we are, standing in your presence. Glory come down, Shekinah glory come down. Here we are, standing in your presence. Here we are, standing in your presence. Shekinah glory come down. Shekinah glory come down. Release the fullness of your spirit. Shekinah glory come. Shekinah. Release the fullness of your spirit. Shekinah glory come. Shekinah glory come. Here we are, standing in your presence. Here we are, standing in your presence. Shekinah glory come down. Shekinah glory. Shekinah glory come down. Shekinah glory come down. Here we are, standing in your presence. Here we are, standing in your presence. Shekinah glory come down. Release the fullness of your spirit. Watch your fullness, release the fullness of your spirit. Shekinah glory come. Shekinah glory come. Release the fullness of your spirit. Shekinah glory come. Shekinah. And you move, and we want more. You speak, and we want more. You move, and we want more. We want your fullness. You move, and we want more. You speak, heart in fullness. Release the fullness of your spirit. Shekinah glory come. Shekinah glory come. Release the fullness of your spirit. Shekinah glory come. Shekinah glory come. You move and we want more. You speak and we want more. You move and we want more. We want your fullness. You move and we want more. You speak and we want more. You move and we want more. We want your fullness.
Oh Lord, let us put our voice together and sing this song. Our God, how excellent is your name. Your name is strength, your name is power, a strong tower. Oh Lord, our God, how excellent is your name. Your name is strength, oh yeah.
Your name is power.
It's power. A strong tower, oh, to keep me safe. Oh, I want to sing.
Yeah.
Jesus.
Nobody like
nobody
you.
Nobody like you, Jesus. Give me the glory and the praise. Yeah.
Stricken my prison, none yet cast down, Lord, but yet I'm not cast away. I say this is the day that you make my knee, Lord. The victory is on my way. The sorrow may be for now. My joy comes in the morning. Yeah, I'm trading my sorrow. Yeah, I'm trading my pain. I'm laying down
for the joy of the Lord.
One more time, I say, yeah, yeah. I'm trading my sorrow. Oh, yeah. I'm trading my pain. Yeah. I'm laying it down for the joy of the Lord. Yeah. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, yes, Lord. Yeah. Yes, Lord, yes, Lord, yes. I say, yeah. One more time, I say, yeah, yeah, yeah.
Yes, Lord, yes, Lord, yes.
Yes, Lord, I say, yeah.
Yes, Lord, yes, Lord, yes.
Yes, Lord.
Lord, yes, Lord,
yeah.
Yes, Lord,
yeah. Yes, Lord, yes, Lord, yes, Lord, yes. Yes, Lord, yes, Lord, yes.
Yes, Lord.
Yes, Lord.
Yes, Lord, yes, yes.
I say, yeah, yeah, yeah. Yeah. Hallelujah.
Praise God. I'm treating my sorrows, I'm treating my sickness and my pain. Well, we're going to be blessed now as we have the Word of God, and I am so glad to introduce to you today the speaker. He is the senior pastor for Campbellville Church and is none other than our beloved Pastor Stephen Vigilance. God bless him.
Praise God. This morning I would like to share with you the Christ of the crisis. And we had some scripture readings this morning, and we had one from St. Matthew's Gospel, chapter 16, verse 15 and 16. It reads us, "And he said unto them, But who say he that I am? And Simon Peter answered and said unto him, Thou art the Christ, the Son of the living God. Father in heaven and our God, we bless you this morning. We pray, O Father, as we come to minister to your word, we pray you're going to anoint feeble lips of clay, that your word will not return unto you void, but it must accomplish the will and its purpose. Bless both speaking here alike, and have your way, O God. For Christ's sake, we ask these mercies. Amen and amen. Praise God, the Christ of the crisis. The word Christ is being used as a title. And there are so many other things that we can see from the word Christ. We saw in the scripture where it referred to as the Holy One. We saw where it referred to as the Anointed One, the Son of the Living God, the Bread of Life, the Bridegroom, the Creator, the light of the world and the life. The word Christ. Jesus Christ asks his disciples, who do men say that I am? What an important question. And Simon was able to say unto him that thou art the Christ. Not a Christ. Thou art the Christ. The Son of the living God. And today we will be looking at the Christ in the crisis, or the Christ of the crisis. Crisis is something that you did not cater for. Something that you did not plan for. Something more than you have control of. And we know that right now, this world is in a crisis. 2 months ago, they had the big crisis of the corona. And we know what it did to the entire world. So many things went wrong. Over 11 million persons were infected. Over 500,000 has passed away. But we thank God, because today we know the Christ of the crisis. He's still alive, and he's still well, and he's still moving in the lives and the hearts of his people. And we know that it doesn't matter how bad the crisis may seem, he's just a prayer away. He's just a prayer away. With the corona, it shut down the world. It shut down the economies. It shut down jobs and income. And it brings with it starvation and death. thank God that in spite of that, we still have the Christ of the crisis. You may be going through a crisis today, but thank God that we have the Christ of the crisis. It reminds me in Exodus chapter 3, verse 7, where God said, I have seen the affliction of my people. I have heard their cry. I have known what is going on, and I have come down to help. Oh, we serve a great, big, wonderful God. It doesn't matter what it may. It doesn't matter how dark it may get. Our God is still dear, and he's here to help. The children of Israel, the Hebrew nation, they were in a crisis. The taskmaster was on their back, and they were requiring of them to do more than what they could have done. They were in a crisis, and in the crisis they prayed and called on God. And God heard their prayer. God said, he heard in Exodus chapter 3 verse 7, I have seen the tears and I have heard their cry. And I have come down to help. I want to tell you, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, today, God is still in the business of helping. So it doesn't matter how dark and bad the crisis may seem. We have the Christ of the crisis. And he's dear to help. And thank God. When he came down, he helped the Hebrew nation. Although at one time it seems like if it was a tug of war, it seems like if Pharaoh would have won. But our God is awesome. He can move mountains. He can keep you in the valley and hide you from the storms. So it doesn't matter how it may seem today. The Christ of the crisis is here to minister to your life and to your heart. And he set his people free. God is still in the helping business. He have seen the tears. He have heard their prayers. And he come down to help. God is still helping today. Hallelujah. There was some other crisis in the Bible. I remember at one time there was a wedding in Canaan. In John chapter 2, verse 1 through to verse 11 tells us about that wedding. And there was an embarrassing situation because the wine ran out. What a wedding. Where are you supposed to be going to have joy? Where are you supposed to go and have fellowship? Something to eat and something to drink. But it was an embarrassing situation. The wine ran out. And Mary, the mother of Jesus, went to him and tell him that the wine ran out. And he said, woman, what must I do? My hour is not yet come. And with the same breath, she went on to say to the servants, do whatsoever he say to you, do it. Although Jesus just said, my hour is not yet come. She was saying to them, whatsoever he say to you, do it. And sometimes I wonder why she would use those words. But even what Jesus said to them filled the water pot seemed like something far-fetched. That's why Mary said to them, whatsoever he said, do it. It seems like if it was something impossible, fill the water pots with water. That's all he requires of them. And sometimes, when we face with situations, it seems impossible. And it doesn't seem logical. But we thank God Because his ways are not our ways. His ways are different from our ways. His thoughts are different from our thoughts. And even as he said to them, fill the water pot. I believe that some of the servants start to look under the eyes. Start to look crossway. In other words, to say, what he's saying? What is that? But they obey and they fill the water pot. And then Jesus said to them, throw out and serve to the governor of the feast first. And even when he drank of the wine, he realized it was different. That had to be a wine man. He knows about wine. He realized that this was a good wine. This is a real preserved wine. Because Jesus was in it. The Christ of the crisis, he stepped in just in time and saved an embarrassing situation. What it would have been for the bride and the bridegroom. What an embarrassing situation it would have been if it had to remain like that. But the Christ of the crisis stepped in and changed the situation. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, I want to say to you, it doesn't matter what you're going through today. The Christ of the crisis is here to minister to your life and to your heart. He wants to bring a difference in your life. But it seems like if you're about to give up, because it seems like all doors are closed and your backs are against the wall. The Christ of the crisis is here. And he's here to minister to your life and your heart. And I trust God that every one of you, before you leave this place, if you haven't met the Christ of the crisis, you're going to meet him today. He's at the crossroad and he's calling. He's saying, come unto me, all ye that labor and heavy laden, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you. Learn of me. My yoke is easy. My burden is light. He's here to help us. The Christ of the crisis. You may be going through some crisis today. And it seems like if the due date is near. But it's no way out. You're in a tight position. You want to give up. There may seem like the only logical thing to give up. Why won't you allow the Christ of the crisis to come true for you? He's here and he wants to minister to you. I remember in the Bible, St. Matthew's Gospel, chapter 8, verse 24 to verse 27 tells us that Jesus said to his disciples, let's go over to the other side. And even as they were in the boat going over, in the ship going over, there was a great storm. And the winds and the waves were hitting the ship. The scripture said that it overtook the ship. And the disciples were all worried and afraid. I guess if I was there, I would have been the same like them. You're in the middle of no man's land. And all you can see around you is water. And there's a great storm. And the winds and the waves overtake the ship. And the disciple went to Jesus, who was resting, and wake him up. Said, Lord, care it not that we perish. Look what is going on the outside. We need your help. And he asks, why are you so fearful? And sometimes in our lives, we face with situations that brings us to our knees. Sometimes in our lives, we face with situations that have us shivering. We fearful, although we know the Christ of the crisis. Sometimes the situations bring us to tears. I believe that the disciples, who were some seasoned fishermen, who saw storms before, but this one was extraordinary. You may be going through a situation today, and it may seem to you like if it's extraordinary. It may seem to you like there is no way out, but Jesus Christ is the way. Jesus Christ is the truth, and he is the life. Praise God. Jesus wants to help you. Jesus wants to bring you through. The songwriter said he didn't bring us this far to leave us. He didn't teach us to swim to let us drown. He didn't build his hope in us to move away. He didn't lift us up to let us down. But he wants to bring us through. We don't know how he's going to take us through the situation, but he's going to take us through. At the end of it, we're going to raise our hands and say to God, be the glory, the honor, and the praise for what he has done. At the end of it, we would acknowledge that this had to be God. This was beyond us. This was beyond me as an individual. This had to be God coming through for me and giving me the victory. And even as Jesus arose and asked his disciples, "O ye of little faith," I wonder if he's saying the same thing to you, Mom. Dad, I wonder if he's saying the same thing to you today. "O ye of little faith, why not put your trust and your confidence in me? For I'm going to take you through." We don't know how he's going to take us through, but we know he's going to take us through. Because he said in his word, "I am going to be with you always, even unto the end." So it doesn't matter what we're going through today. Jesus is going to be with you. The Christ of the crisis is going to be with you. So it doesn't matter what is the crisis that exists within our lives. The Christ of the crisis is going to take us through. Hallelujah. And as he awoke from his sleep and he rebuked the winds and the sea, and there was a great calm. So a few minutes ago, there was a great storm. And now there is a great calm because of the Christ of the crisis. Mom, it may seem like a great storm within your life. And we may even use the little phrase that we say, old house upon old house. But I want to say to you today that the Christ of the crisis is here to rebuke the storms and the sea. It seems like if you're going under, the water is much more than you. The problems is more than you can. But the Christ of the crisis is here to help you. I trust God that you would allow him to come true for you. The Bible tells us in John chapter 6, verse 1 through to verse 12, about a situation where Jesus was preaching in the desert. And after a pretty long time, the people were hungry. And he asked Philip, where we can get some bread to buy so we can feed them. But he knew what he would have done. He already had a plan. And they said, there is no way we can get some bread to buy. Even if we get 200 penny loaves, it would not be enough. But he knew what he would have done. And the scripture tells us that there was a little lad who had 5 barley loaves and 2 fishes. And Jesus lifted up and prayed and asked the Father to bless it. And even as he asked the Father to bless it, they put the men and women to sit down and the children. And the scriptures say that they were able to feed them. More than 5,000 men besides children and women. And Jesus did it because he is the Christ of the crisis. 200 penny loaves would not be enough. And sometimes that's how we reason. The little that we have and the little that we would get from here and get from there would not be enough. But we are serving the Christ of the crisis, a great, big, wonderful God. A God that says he's going to supply our needs according to his riches in glory. Not according to our riches, but according to his riches in glory. He's going to supply our need. And at the end of it, there were 12 baskets of fragments. 12 baskets that were left over. And that's the God we serve who promised to give us the pressed down, shaken together and running over measure. Not a sparing God, but in abundance. What you're going through today is no surprise to the Christ of the crisis. Our Lord don't have to pull his hair out his head and wonder what to do. Like when the pandemic first started, there was mass confusion. What to do? The great big America had plans and had things in place for pandemic, but it was beyond them. But today, we have the Christ of the crisis who controls this universe. And he wants to make a difference in your life. So whatever you're going through today, the Christ of the crisis is here to minister to you. Let's bow our hearts in prayer and let's talk to the Christ of the crisis. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, the Christ of the crisis is here, and he's here to help. Let's talk to him. Praise God. Father in heaven and our God, we bless you today. We thank thee for the ministry of your word. We thank thee because you are the Christ of the crisis. And in spite of what we may be going through, and it seems like if there is no way out, we thank thee because we can rest secure that you're going to make a way where there is no way. Hear the cry of your people today, Lord. Minister to the lives and their hearts and turn the situation around. That we'd have a testimony of the goodness of the Lord. That when we were about to give up, the Lord came through for us and gave us the victory. So we give you the praise, we give you the honor, we give you the glory. Have your way into our lives. For Christ's sake, we ask these mercies. Amen and amen. Praise God. Turn to your brother, turn to your sister, and tell them I know the Christ of the crisis. God bless you.
Thank you, Pastor Steve, for such a timely word. I know it is from the Lord, because many of us are going through this crisis, whether it be storms, whether it be battles. I declare in Jesus' name, as you reach out to him, like the songwriter says, reach out to Jesus, he's reaching out to you, that you will see defeats turn into victories, needs supply, storms come, all because you're reaching out to the Christ of the crisis. God bless you. Please join us again next Sunday at around 10:30 a.m. when we meet together for another worship time live stream. And don't forget, join us on Thursday for our Bible study and on Friday for our prayer meeting at 7 p.m. God bless you. Have a pleasant rest of the day.
Good morning. This morning my song is titled, The Power of Your Love. Lord, I come to you. Let my heart be changed, renewed, flowing from the grace that I found in you. Lord, I've come to know the weaknesses I see in me will be stripped away by the power of your love. Hold me close and let your love surround. Draw me to your side.
Spirit leads me on.